When this pandemic started, my husband and I had an argument about me going to work. He knew it wasn't safe. Me being in the hospital made me more susceptible to the virus. Ma, stay at home. The kids are still small. We need you here at home. But how could I not help? We had doctors and staff getting sick left and right. They were being quarantined. We had to adjust the schedule so many times to fill in the gaps. It wasn't easy for my husband, but somehow he understood that I just couldn't sit this one out. Now I go on duty at the hospital 4 to 5 times a week, 12-hour shifts at a time. A typical day for me would be waking up at 5:30 as my shift starts at 7. I take a shower, have a full breakfast, dress up, and kiss the kids goodbye. I find that it is easiest for me to leave when the kids are still asleep, so they don't cling to me or cry when I leave. In the car, I say a prayer. I pray for strength to last me through the day. I pray for protection for me, for my team, for the people I leave behind at home. I pray for my patients that somehow I'll be able to help them. When I get to the hospital, I change into the scrubs that they provide for me. I don my PPE. The PPE is not the most comfortable thing to wear. We either wear the isolation gowns or the very hot bunny suits. We have to wear the tight-fitting N95 masks, which makes it hard for us to breathe. But I'm very thankful for the PPE. It keeps us protected. The PPE is now my best friend. We wear the PPEs for hours. We wear it for as long as we can. When we're wearing the PPE, we don't eat, we don't drink, we don't go to the bathroom. If I need to eat, I usually have lunch at around 4 o'clock, where I know I'll have the call room to myself. I usually am afraid to eat because I find that I'm more susceptible to getting the virus when I have my mask off. In the ER, we see COVID patients every day. We have our good days and our bad days. A bad day would be when a walking, talking patient would crash in front of us and eventually code, or when a patient we've been taking care of for days would deteriorate and eventually expire. A good day would be meeting somebody we saw previously who's positive for COVID, who's now asymptomatic and is at the ER to get another swab. After my 12-hour shift, I take a shower in the hospital and I change back into my original clothes. When I get home, I would head for the back door where I know there would be a pail waiting for me. I would undress, put all my clothes there, spray it with Lysol, and then cover it. I take another shower when I get home, and only then will I be able to engage with the people at home. My husband and I would have dinner, which would be usually around 9 o'clock. He'd talk about his day and I'd talk about mine. After that, we'd be going to the room, which would be my favorite time of the day, because I know as soon as I open the door, my kids will be rushing towards me and you'd hear the, "I'm first to kiss mommy." I hug my kids as long as I can and as much as I can, because I don't know when the next time I can do that again will be. I know that if I get sick, I'd have to isolate myself from them, which may take 2 weeks or a month or maybe even longer. When I'm not at work, I try not to think about the hospital. I spend time with my kids. I teach my 11-year-old daughter. She still has school and they do online learning. I play with my 4-year-old son and I breastfeed my 8-month-old baby. Oftentimes, I feel guilty because I no longer pump milk when I'm at work. I try to avoid bringing home things from the hospital. She has finished all my breast milk stores in the freezer, so we've started her on formula feeding. Sometimes we'd have the occasional movie night at home. My co-doctors at work tell me it's a good thing you don't get scared going home after your duty. But I do get scared. In fact, I'm terrified. I'm afraid to bring the virus home. But I also know that I'm needed at home. That's why I make it a point to be careful in my donning and doffing of the PPE. I try to avoid socializing when I'm at work if I'm not yet wearing my PPE. I follow all the rules and I pray hard that I don't get sick. By the look of things, this is not something that will go away in the next few weeks or maybe even the next few months. I'm guessing this will last maybe until the end of the year. I can't not see my kids for that long. I believe my children need their mom the same way my patients need their doctor. Never in my life had I imagined that I would make the hard decision of going to work every day, that I would find myself in the front line of a battle where we don't even see the enemy. My sister calls me her hero, but I don't want to be a hero. I just want to live through this. I want all of us to live through this. So until when will I keep doing this? I guess maybe until I can do this. If I won't do it, who will?